and software and so on. But if you draw a line all the way around it, the money going over the line has to equal the money, you know, going the other way, right? Otherwise, it doesn't add up to zero, you know, to zero. So we need to make sure that money comes in from somewhere, so we can spend it on, you know, people doing good work, whatever that is, whether it's training, migration, developing the code, supporting and so on. Some people never grasp this. I would encourage you to think over this simple truth, because it's really extremely important. Some people have this, which is a money fairy. People with money fairies are very lucky. I think we can think of several notable, very rich people who just give money, you know? And supposedly, you know, it's spent on good works and so on. And this model's great, if you have it. But for the rest of us, we have to actually, you know, please a customer. You know, every euro we spend, you know, paying for meals for people, flying people, telling people about free software, sponsoring conferences, marketing, whatever, comes from a customer. So it seems obvious. And so that means the customer is, you know, is the king. You know, they are the boss. You know, have you dealt with a small to medium enterprise? Because you really matter. As a customer, you matter. We come and listen to you, and hopefully we do what you want and we satisfy you. We have a big team to do that. Just to go and talk to customers, to market, to tell them about LibreOffice, to tell them how great it is, and to dress up in city suits with ties and collars and look like the kind of people they want to do business with. There's a lot more to it than that, and we have a, you know, a team of people acquiring and pulling people into the ecosystem, dragging them in so they can contribute and help all of us get a better product wherever we are. Of course, it's an expensive hobby. So I spend a lot of hours doing tedious stuff so my team can hack and hopefully have fun. And we'll see some of what they do in a minute. But, you know, sitting in conference calls endlessly, emailing people in person, pitching the benefits, the savings, the wins around profits, and listening to their problems and explaining how we can easily fix that and, you know, and help them win. So that's all good fun. So what do we do? What have we done? So this is this is another beginning. Just to try and get this message across, to repeat it. You can consider Collabra as a machine that turns coins into good things, you know, for you. So support for you, your customers, peace of mind, new features, you want them, you want to squash all the bugs, you know, you want it to work better. We can do all of that, right? That's a, and I'll just give some examples of how we do that as consulting. So just stuff we've done in the last year. So performance. We look through the source code and we find things that say fast in them, and then we actually make them fast. You know, so it is a horrible misnomer in our legacy code. So the fast serializer, it turns out, was doing a system call. If you're a programmer, this is quite a slow thing. You know, writing tiny fragments of XML, you know, an attribute name, an equals, an open quote, another attribute name, up to millions of system calls, and just, you know, huge, huge wins possible there. You know, 30% speed up, XLSX export, just with relatively small bits of buffering code. But it was profiling, working, and, you know, selling this to people. We threaded the zip export, so when you save a file, an ODF file, you create lots of bits, lots of ingredients, then go into the zip file. And packing into the zip thing happens right at the end, so we thought, great, we can speed this up, we'll thread it. It turns out that actually, the vast majority of the cost was compressing images, which are already compressed. So when we dug into it, having threaded it, it turns out your JPEG images, you know, have already been heavily compressed, and then half of them compressed, and then we zipped them and go, oh, it got bigger, let's not do that. And throwing the results away. So actually, the threading and the zip export was not necessary once you tackled the real causes of the problem, which is doing stupid stuff like that. But again, just finding this and fixing it and making things quicker for everyone. And while we were doing that, we found some of, well, we refactored the image handling because there's been a perennial